So welcome. Can you believe it's been 25? Oh, I'm gonna cry already. It's gonna be one of those nights. 25 years. 25 years. Now's the time. All right. So there's a couple of housekeeping things I just want to fill everyone in on. First of all, is that we know a lot of you are proud family members who want to grab photos and all of that. And we encourage you to do so, but we just ask that you also be thoughtful and remember if you're going to post any of them. If there are any members of the class that are not members of your family, we just ask you to be conscious about, would you want that picture showing up on someone else's Facebook page, if that were you. And if there are any family members here that are concerned about any, right now, as far as I know, everyone does have a consent form for photos. But if there is anybody that is uncomfortable or has a challenge with any photos, let us know so that we can announce and make sure that folks do not get any of those pictures out there, because we know what goes on the web stays on there forever.
Yep.
Right?
Right.
Yes, and you'll see that. And how many of you caught our Facebook Live the other day when we were doing the three? I saw two hearts and one thumbs up. So the four people are here. Thank you. So if you go to our Facebook page, I'm so excited to tell you that Facebook decided to start me with my mouth wide open in a frozen shot. So I'm so excited about that. Can hardly tell you. But anyway, welcome. We are delighted to be here for our 25th anniversary celebration of UpReach. And we have so much to share with you tonight about what our current participants are doing, as well as some history of some things that we have gone through over the years, where we're at now, some exciting news for the future. I'm going to introduce some folks to you a little later that have been with us participating in the program almost since the very, very, very beginning. So that's very cool as well. If you need to use the restroom, there is one right behind you all. So it is there. There's lots of refreshments. So help yourselves. If you need to get up in the middle of a session, I just ask you to do so quietly and conscious of the people that are around you. But feel free to get up, grab a snack, bring it in, drinks and all that. Just bring it on in, because I don't want to take any of it home. And if there's anything left, I promised it to our tomb, our VISTA coordinator that's here doing her year of service, and our intern. So whatever you don't eat, they are going to take and eat for you. And I just want to let you know that while we are excited to celebrate tonight, we're going to ask you, the energy in the room is going to be extremely high, and our horses feed off that energy, and we all feed off that energy as well. So we're going to ask you to help us keep that energy a little bit contained by doing a horse show applause. So when we're excited and we want to show our applause, the horse show applause, Laura, you were going to demonstrate. What is horse show applause?
Show how to. Show them jump.
Okay, can you turn that way and show them too, Vanna? There we go. Thank you, Laura. All right, so I will quite often say, how about another round of applause? And when I say that, you will do what? Perfect. Perfect. All right, I'm going to ask Wesley and Ben to do the presentation of colors. I'm going to ask all of you who can to please stand and join me as we salute the flag and we say, I'm going to sing the Star Spangled Banner. Feel free to join in. Oh, say can you see, dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's relic, the bombs bursting in air, gave spangled banner yet wave. For the land of the free and the home of the brave. Thank you, Wesley and Ben. How about a nice horseshoe round of applause for our two flag bearers? Now I have to put my glasses back on. So 20 years ago, I didn't need my glasses to do this. So I have aged along with Will Diener. He and I are the only two who have aged in 20 years. Right, Will? You look fine. You look fine. So the first demonstration we're going to have for you this evening is a therapeutic driving demonstration. So they are busy putting the horses to the carts. Clarissa and Lulu are our two driving horses. Currently, both Lauren and Kristen are PATH certified therapeutic driving instructors, and I'm pleased to say that Liz has just begun the long process of becoming a PATH certified driving instructor as well. So congratulations, Liz. Welcome to your many hours of driving training, and we look forward to adding you as a certified therapeutic driving instructor. I also need to give special kudos to Celeste, as well as to Chuck, who are both able-bodied whips. There is a tremendous amount of driving training and hours in the cart and learning harnessing and parts of the harness and all of those types of things that they had to go through to be certified to actually sit in the cart with the students while the instructor teaches outside of the cart on the ground. So we have a nice horseshoe round of applause for Chuck and Celeste, because that's a huge commitment of time and we're very grateful for that. I think it's just weird for me because y'all are so quiet, but you're supposed to be, so good for you. They're following directions. Nice. So how many of you are here because you are here to see someone who is actually going to be doing a demonstration? There's a family member. How many of you are coworkers of someone perhaps that's coming? And how many of you are volunteers? How many here are volunteers? Well, good to see you. Thank you. How many of you are first-time visitors? Wow, well, welcome. Welcome to the barn. We hope that this will be the first of many visits. We have a lot to share and a lot to show. More importantly, I think that if you're a first-time visitor, I encourage you to share that we are always looking for folks who are interested in volunteering, whether it's in the barn, in the lessons, in the office. Veronica and I are really nice. We need volunteers, too. But everyone seems to want to be out in the barn with the horses. I get it. We can bring a small pony in the office. We can do that. We have the capacity to do that. More importantly, though, if you know someone who might be able to benefit from some of our programs and services, and throughout the evening I'll be talking about therapeutic driving, therapeutic riding, I'll be talking about our equine-facilitated mental health services, our equine-assisted learning programs that are curriculum-based programs that work with bullying, that work with self-esteem and confidence. They can we're looking at doing a trauma group for youngsters who have experienced some type of trauma in the household, whether it's abuse or they've just been exposed to someone with an addiction problem or any of those types of things. And they're coming in, you know, the police department may be coming in and giving the parents counseling and sending them, but who's taking care of the kids? And so that's one of the things that we're working on doing, to provide some equine-assisted opportunities along those lines as well. We also have a juvenile diversion state-accredited program. We are using all of our programs are applicable and can be focused in for specific needs for veterans. So we're looking forward to working with the Wounded Warrior Project, who's coming here on the 24th. To do an afternoon experience with some of the Wounded Warrior veterans, and then we're hoping that will transition into a Wounded Warrior support group with some additional equine-assisted activities to support some of that work as well. So there's a lot of different ways that we can partner with the horse to improve lives. So if you have anyone that you think that might be remotely a possibility for them to participate with, or they can help us provide those services, or are looking to provide services such as that, they may be a mental health professional or a nurse practitioner or a LADAC or someone along those lines, put them in touch with us so we can follow up and talk about programming. So Kristen is driving Clarissa. Let me tell you a little bit about Clarissa. Clarissa is a 17-year-old Haflinger mare. She provides her riders with strong lateral movement. She's also our driving queen and loves to pull the cart and share her skills with her students. Her forward energy and movement provides lots of input. And Clarissa is quite photogenic. You will see that she's quite often the horse, poster horse for a lot of our programming. Not to diminish what Lulu brings to the table by any means. She's a 20-year-old Haflinger mare. How many of you remember the demo nights years and years and years ago when I said everybody wanted a Haflinger? We finally have one. And now we have one, two, three, four. Yeah, we have a Haflinger barn now. And one Gypsy Vanner. Yes, Sadie, I got it. You'll get your kudos even though you're not going to be in the ring tonight. But anyway, Lulu is a 20-year-old Haflinger mare. She's known for standing quietly in the ramp while the students transfer from wheelchair to horseback. She's a sturdy pony who can carry both an adult's weight without being too tall for sidewalkers to provide the necessary support. And she loves to drive. Fine. We're just assessing your driving skills. Does anybody need a marker and a piece of paper so that we can rate how Lauren and Kristen are doing? Personally, I think they're 11s. I hope they heard me say I think they're 11s. On a scale of 1 to 10, you're both 11. So for those of you who might not have noticed or have noticed, there's a difference in the two carts. Kristen is driving the wheelchair accessible cart that can be used both as a regular cart with a seat, or the seat can come out and a wheelchair can go up in. And then Lauren is certainly driving the not a wheelchair accessible cart. So are you ready for your first two drivers?
I'm ready for Kristen to move.
Excuse me, we seem to have a parking problem in the building. And so it begins, people. Welcome to my world. So Lauren, Betsy wanted me to make sure that you knew that she would like some assistance getting into the car.
That's what we have Jim for.
How are you doing?
Better be on my toes because Celeste's over here with a whip. So it looks like, unfortunately, Sarah hasn't arrived yet, who is going to be participating in this demonstration. So Kristen is just going to... Lauren, you just tell Kristen what you'd like her to do. I'll let Lauren make that decision. But I am delighted to say that Betsy McMahon is going to be in the very first demo this evening, in the driving demo, and it seems fitting because I think Betsy has probably been here the longest. How many years? Out of the 25? 24 and a half, pretty much. So Betsy is fitting that she's been here almost 25 years participating in the program, starting off on horseback. Betsy transitioned to driving a few years ago, and one of the really great things for Betsy about driving is that she can go fast. And I'm sure we'll see that in just a little bit. So we are delighted to have Betsy. She's quite a celebrity here this evening. So how about a horse show round of applause for our celebrity Betsy McMahon? Okay, so Betsy's been working on her independent driving skills and lessons. And in lessons, Betsy is the only one that has a set of reins. Tonight, because of, again, the energy in the room and there's just so much going on, to err on the side of caution, there's another set as well. But in her lessons, Betsy is in control of the cart herself at all times. And then she is learning driving dressage patterns and improving the execution, and I think they're going to show us some patterns here in a little bit. Nice job, Betsy. Having a nice horse show round of applause for Kristen and Clarissa. Aren't they doing a great job just being still and quiet? Yeah. Hey, that's important too. So again, the benefits of therapeutic driving still, again, allow for an individual to participate in an equine experience. And although it's not mounted, it's still a very powerful experience. They can work on spatial awareness and orientation. Again, if you can learn how to drive and steer a horse, the transition to driving a motorized vehicle is much easier. One of Betsy's favorite words, trot. Well, Betsy couldn't trot when she was riding on horseback. It was a contraindication for her. It wasn't safe for her to do so. And so again, the freedom of being able to be in the cart, have control, and have that fulfill that need for speed, it's a very powerful thing. Again, when we talk about spatial awareness and orientation, that's what makes sure that Betsy doesn't drive into the cones or over the cones. Spatial awareness and orientation is something we all take for granted quite often. It what means that we walk through the doorway instead of into the doorway. It means that we can successfully put one pant leg on and then the other pant leg on without falling. Well, most of us will. But I'm going to pick on you all night tonight. You sat in the perfect place. Had Alyssa sat there, it would have been different. But But look at how smoothly she navigates through the cones, and that's a pretty tight fit. Ask if anyone has a chance to ask Liz, because Liz is still learning. So they have completed their demonstration for this evening. We're going to ask the ringmaster to come forward with the presentation of our special 25th anniversary medals and certificates. And I think, Tom, I think Wesley's going to help you. Can you help? You want to help, Tom? There you go. Nice. So again, another horse show round of applause for our celebrity, to Betsy McMahon, who has been participating here all since the very beginning, and we are blessed to still have her with us, bringing her smile, her energy, and her wonderful personality to the barn. It's a delight to have her here. And then Jim, when the time comes, I'm sure Betsy would like your assistance. She specifically asked for you, I believe. Thank you, Wesley, for your help. We're gonna follow that with another driving demonstration. So in just a moment, we're gonna ask Nate and Laura to come forward, but be patient. But as long as you are at the ready, we will let you know as soon as we are ready for you. Nice job, Jim. How about a nice round of applause for Jim? He's been practicing that move for weeks now. Are you ready for your next drivers? Laura, hold on. Someone will open the, move the pole for you, my dear. And is Nate here? I think I saw him. Yes, he is.
Nate, you're in luck. This is McGraw's day.
Hi, Nate.
No, no.
Yes.
Nate, actually, you're going to be driving with Kristen and Clarissa today. Now, Laura is a celebrity as well, because although Laura hasn't been here quite as long as Betsy, she's been here almost as long as Betsy. So we are delighted to have Laura. And Laura started out in the riding program as well and has transitioned to driving. She's continuing to improve and increase her variety of horse equestrian skills. Again, just for those of you who may not have caught that, when the driver is ready, the driver indicates my horse, and that way the header unhooks and relinquishes control to the people in the cart. Kristen and Nate are driving Clarissa. Nate is developing accurate steering within a variety of activities. He's also working on utilizing his voice and rein to stop his horse with increasing independence. And he's been driving at UpReach for just about a year. Decided that he would like to do red light, green light. They are going to do that quietly to themselves, so I will not be saying red light, green light, because we don't want to disrupt what Laura is going to be doing as well. But if you see the cart starting and stopping, that means they're doing red light, green light.
Oh! Laura would like to tell you what we're doing while they do.
And what are you doing while they do red light, green light? Dropping the ball in the bucket. Her favorite game in the world.
Laura is stopping precisely, right, and some problem solving during this activity.
Okay, so efficient steering.
Precise stopping.
Precise stopping.
Only if you're not precise when you stop.
And backing up if they're not precise when they stop. And then problem solving along the way.
Ready?
Let's
do it.
Okay.
We'll
talk. Laura is definitely in charge.
Hey.
I said Lauren.
Oh, okay.
Oh, Lauren.
Laura, Lauren. So again, when we talk about precise steering, look how close to the sidewall that she is. And if you were in a driving class, that's one of the things they want you to stay on the rail. Of course, unless they don't, but most often they do.
Nice job with the reins. Green light. Nice done. One more time, then we'll
go. Okay, and you just draw your attention to the center ring, and Laura's going to see if she can get close enough to get the ball in the bucket. Nice, 2 points. Nice. What do you say, Dad? What do you say, Coach Lemire? Nice.
Go.
Nicely done. So a little bit of history. I remember many, many years ago when they met, do any of you remember Amy Timpson? When Amy Timpson was here, and she was the first driving instructor we had. And I remember Kristen quite vehemently saying she wanted no part of driving. And slowly but surely, with some training and education, nice backing up. But with some additional training and additional knowledge about the benefits of therapeutic riding, Kristen soon engaged in the process of becoming a certified instructor. She was very helpful in coordinating us with the LSES Foundation, who helped provide one of our first therapeutic driving horses. And one of Lauren's very first things that she did here when she was interning here as a student of Colby Sawyer was to help write a grant for the wheelchair accessible cart. So those funds, in conjunction with the auction at one of the earlier hoedowns. How many of you remember the hoedown? How many of you moved carpets for the hoedown? How many of you glad we never have to move carpets again for the hoedown? But that was how we got our very first wheelchair accessible cart, and we're delighted to say that we have about 16 to 18 participants in the driving program, and it's growing and expanding faster than we can keep pace. You know, that's precise driving when Nate comes that close to Chuck and Chuck didn't have to move his toes. Well done. No one saw that. Well, we saw Jim do that, but... I don't know, she's playing like the Cavaliers now. Ooh. See, how many of you are shocked that I even know the Cavaliers are playing? Most of my family would be shocked. I know just enough to know it's the Cavs and the Warriors. And the Warriors are like ahead, right? 3-0. King James is going down. Okay. See, that's the extent of my knowledge, but it sounded good, didn't it? Horse show round of applause for me. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Of course, I'll go out and my car will be egged by all of the Cavalier fans. So when we talk about future, next 25 years, so right now, if you're in the therapeutic riding program, you have the opportunity to take your horse out on the sensory trail and enjoy a ride through the woods. How cool would it be for us to put on our radar to be able to expand the use of the trail to include our carriage driving program? So I say that, and I see some heads nodding, which means that at some point we're going to be putting an ask out to ask for some folks to come out with chainsaws and rakes and shovels to help make that happen. So I hope that those of you who are nodding your head have somebody you can volunteer. If not yourself, someone you can volunteer, your husband, strong children perhaps, to come out and help us make that possible. Even if we had one small loop of the trail to do that, I think that would really be an exciting next 25-year goal for all of us. And I certainly know that Lulu and Clarissa would like the change of pace. So again, a horse show round of applause for Nate and Betsy. I'm sorry, Nate and Laura for doing such an outstanding job. And again, for all of their volunteers that help make sure that their driving is safe and appropriate. So again, a nice job, and thank you to our ringmaster, Tom, for delivering certificates, and his fine associate, Wesley. And this year we have some special 25th anniversary medallions that each of our participants will receive tonight. So thank you to Davis and Toll for being our Blue Ribbon sponsor and helping us to make sure that everyone receives such a wonderful medallion for participating this evening. All right, so while they're unhooking the horses, I'd like to introduce you to someone. Jake, do you want to come and say a few words? Wesley, if you could do me a favor and go back with the ringmaster and plot your next plan of action. Jake is one of those volunteers that the staff always loves to see him come in the barn. He's willing to do whatever is needed. He just has that wonderful positive energy about him, and it's just always a delight when he shows up and can lend a hand. We are so grateful that he is back from college and that he is ours once again until we have to release him at the end of the summer. But until then, I'd like to ask Jake if he will share a few words about his volunteer experience and what he's learned about the power of working with the horse.
Hello, everyone. I'm going to go over here because I feel like that's way more fun than just standing over there, and I can do a little dance for you, whatever I need to do. I just want to talk a little about my volunteer experience here, and it's hard to put it in a few words and only spend a little bit talking about it because of how much it has impacted my life. Before I started volunteering here about probably 2 years ago now, I don't know, I lost track of time, but I was kind of just a different person. Like, I wasn't as confident, and I came here and was greeted with open arms, and it was like a great family to kind of step into, and I've become a lot more confident with just my daily life, which is super awesome. And I have seen the power of a horse, and I know probably heard that, and maybe some people don't quite get it, and it's kind of hard to understand until you experience or to see someone else experience it. But I see some people who come here who have a hard time to talk, or they can't express themselves very well, and then they get on the horse and I see a different person. It's someone who is much more relaxed or has much more energy or whatever it is, but it definitely changes them. And that experience, just seeing that change in some people and the ability that it has to help people is something that I really enjoy. A shameless little plug, definitely if you know someone who wants to volunteer or you want to volunteer, do it. Like I said, I can't tell you enough if you have any questions or anything. I'll be happy to answer. I've been doing it for a while. I hope you guys enjoy the rest of the show, and we'll get it back to Karen.
Nice round of applause for Jake. Can I say, Jake just has a very special energy about him, and he touched on something that's really important to us. One of the things that we really strive to be is a family. We want this to be a place where you feel like you walk in the door in your home, that you are comfortable, that you are safe, that while it's not so much about what happens at the barn stays at the barn, because it doesn't, it transfers out of the barn in so many ways that are so powerful. But we want you to feel like you can share with us how your day's been going. If it's been going well, great, then we want to try to help continue that. If it hasn't been going so great, well, what can we do to make it better? We are so fortunate that we have over 120 volunteers a week that come in and work in the program. We have, as I said, I think 16 to 20 driving students, between 50 and 60 therapeutic riding students. Sarah Jane treats probably, I think, 6 or 7 individuals in the equine facilitated mental health program. And then we, of course, have comments from the horses as well. But we want the community to feel welcome here too. So if you're a first-time guest or you've been a guest here a half a dozen times, we hope it's because you feel like when you walk in the door, you're part of the family. We certainly encourage that with the staff. We spend a lot of hours here. So we need to find a way to make it work. And we spend time making sure we're taking care of each other as much as we're taking care of our horses and our clients and our volunteers. So if I can direct your attention to Lauren in the ring, one of the things that's really important to us is making sure that we have the highest quality, safest practices possible. Safety is our first and highest regard for the client, for the horse, for the volunteer. It's a triangle, and each of those pieces has to be equally as important in order for us to be successful. If our horses aren't happy, they're not safe. If our clients aren't safe, that's a problem. Our volunteers need to be safe, or they're not going to come back and do what they do. And we need that help and that support. So it's a very much a partnership and a team effort in what needs to happen to ensure that they're safe. So Lauren and all of these certified instructors do a safety check of all of the tack and equipment. Before the student gets on, and then they'll do another safety check and adjustments after the student is on the horse. And if there's anything along the way that they notice or feel might be uncomfortable about based on the way a horse is moving or a client is moving, then that might be an issue. So I'll draw your attention to the very far end of the ring, and we have a mounting block, and the mounting block is in easier way for a lot of our students to be able to safely mount the horse. We don't do mounting from the ground. We always use either the block or the ramp. Mounting from the ground usually tends for you to hold on to the saddle or whatever, and then it usually twists and it ends up twisting or something compromising the horse. So this is a much safer mounting technique for horses as well. We also have an electronic lift. So if someone needs some additional support to be able to safely transfer onto the back of the horse, we can use the lift to provide the dignified and safe and appropriate way to ensure the safety of the rider getting onto the back of the horse as well. So coming down the side right now, you have Bill, and Bill is riding Watson. Bill has been participating in the program for quite some time as well, and is a regular participant at Demo Night, and we are delighted to have him here this evening.
Five,
And kudos to whoever made Watson look clean. They were all talking about giving horses baths today, and they was like, well, Watson, he's a white horse, he probably should take a bath, but then he'll roll in something and be worse. And the dilemma we have. And then we have Sophia, who's riding Dawson. And I have it on good authority that Sophia likes country music. And in particular, she's a Luke Bryan fan. And I say that's just fine with me. And last but not least, we have Daniela, who is mounting Nellie. We'll give them a chance to get warmed up, and then I know they have a special demonstration to music that they want to do for you. Looking good, girl.
Hi, Wes.
Kristen, just let me know when you're ready. And then we'll see how well I do with the technology piece of the evening. So we'd like to thank Bill Wynne from Goffstown today. He is here filming. So as soon as we have an edited product, we'll let you know. But we are delighted that he was kind enough to come down on his own time and take some footage so that we can share a bit more about what we do. Yes, Nellie, everyone thinks you're beautiful. And Daniela, you too. Nellie's the horse, Danielle's the rider, just to make sure everyone's clear. How long has Daniela been riding? Do you know? About three terms, so what? 20 weeks, 24 weeks, 28 weeks? So she is doing a fine job. And I was going to say, I believe she's just, is she in a saddle? No, she's just on pony, right? One Western, one English, and one just with a bareback pad. And we'll give them a second to warm up, and then we'll be underway with their demonstration. Look good, so.
Not music yet.
So, Bill, my closing trot. Down the one side.
Or now. Bill's gonna do a nice posting trot down the one side. Nice job. Well done. So, a little bit of a history lesson. I remember when Bill used to ride Aerostar. I'm going to remember Aerostar, and boy, Bill was one of the few that could actually get Aerostar to go. Nice job. Well done, Daniela and Nelly. How about a horse show round of applause for all of them? That was a good job. And I will try to comply and make it happen. 25 years ago, we didn't have this.
Do you need help?
Just saying. Okay. Try again. Try again.
Here, let me see it. It's Mom's phone, isn't it?
Oh, yes, thank you. Alyssa, save me. Okay, well, I'm not quite ready yet, but as soon I know to push that button and then push the play button when it's time. Okay, I think I got it. Why don't you stay right here? My technology IT person, Alyssa Stakely. Otherwise known as Kristen's daughter. Sorry. Yeah, it just goes with the territory. I understand there was a toss-up of songs, whether it was going to be the theme from the Pirates of the Caribbean, or Caribbean, depending upon how you sing, or Cotton Eye Joe. I'll let you listen to what they chose. I have my IT person on it.
Thank you.
nice horse show round of applause. That was excellent. Well done. Well done on behalf of the horses, the riders, and the volunteers. That was a workout. So we're going to ask our horses to line up, and then we'll have our ringmasters come out for presentations of medallions and certificates. Hold on, Wesley. Let's get them lined up, okay?
All right.
So just a little bit of information while we're all settling down now. Bill, who is in the middle, is working on posting on the correct diagonal and maintaining the trot, and I think he did an outstanding job this evening. He's been riding at UpReach for 15 years, and he enjoys riding outside on the trail. Sophia is working on developing independent skills, specifically her rein use. She did a really nice job this evening, and she is very social, enjoys her relationship with the volunteers and other riders. And then Daniela, who has been riding the least amount of time of the group, did an outstanding job as well. She loves to ride bareback. And she's quickly learned the pattern and does a great job maintaining proper spacing, which is a safety issue. And she works on effective use of reins to steer and stop. Again, a nice job on behalf of all three of our participants in this wonderful demonstration. How about one final horse show round of applause? And for Watson, Nellie, and Dawson as well. We couldn't do it without those trusty steeds. Thank you. So, Christine. I remember meeting Christine in 1996 for me, that I first met you when Karen Morgan and Pony Express was invited to come and sing at the very first hoedown. And you were so kind as to be helping with the auction, and that was a huge undertaking. And Jane has been participating here for 20 plus years. So I know that Lauren spoke to you and asked you if you'd say a few words, and you found something from one of the original hoedowns. Yeah, I haven't gotten it. No, sorry. I actually might have had one if I'd have dug deep. But I'm going to introduce you to Jane. I'm sorry, Jane's mom, Christina.
My daughter Jane has been riding here at UpReach for over 20 years. The other day, I found a page from an old hoedown program booklet that had a picture of a very young Jane. It brought back memories of when she started riding here. At the time, I couldn't imagine how she would ever be able to stay on a horse, let alone ride one. But it quickly became clear that she felt right at home in the saddle. Jane bonded with the horses, especially her beloved Marmalade, who she rode for many years, and whose name was one of the few words that Jane would say. Her weekly lesson made her so happy, as it still does today. We cherish the time Jane comes to UpReach because, in addition to the therapeutic benefits, it is her time, doing an activity she loves on her own. Being the parent of a child with a disability can often feel lonely, even after 31 years. We have, from the start, found a refuge here. A place where we don't need to explain about our lives. A place where we are comfortable and feel comforted. We are so grateful for the volunteers, the staff, and the wonderful horses that for an hour a week enable our Jane to feel like an ordinary girl on her horse.
Okay, it happened again. But that's what we want. Isn't that what we all want for our children and our loved ones? A sense of belonging, a sense of wholeness. Wholeness means so much more than whether you're in a wheelchair or you're not, or you have to use a walker or you don't. I think we can all sense when someone feels that sense of self, of wholeness, of belonging. And if that's what UpReach can be, then we've done it right.
and that's enough. So 25 years. We had a devastating experience in the year 2000. In March of 2000, I remember very clearly getting a call from the barn manager saying, Karen, you need to come down to the barn, the roof is collapsing. I have never driven so fast from New Boston to Goffstown in my entire life. And I'm just blessed that the good Lord was watching over me to make sure here I arrive safely. The good news was the staff had been able to quickly take all the horses out of the building and ensure that everyone was safe. And it was 8:30, 9 o'clock at night, so no one was riding, and I believe it was a Saturday or Sunday. But as a struggling nonprofit in 2000 with no cash reserves, plenty of debt, but a staff with more heart than you will ever, ever know, we sat outside and we said, UpReach is not a building, it's who we are as people. It's the volunteers, it's the horses, it's the staff, it's the community. And I have never been so blessed to have the community rally around us as they did in that year. The Singer family added on to their facility at Mansion Stables just down, about 6 miles down the road, so that we could move almost all of our program horses there and still run lessons. That was when Edie Loeb-Tomasko transferred the donation of the house up on the hill, that parcel of property, over to UpReach so that we could move the barn manager and her family that was living in the apartment upstairs into the first floor of the house, and UpReach offices went into the lower level of the house. And from March to December, we trucked all the way over every day, 6 miles down the road to make sure we took care of horses and still ran programming in full, and moved back into the barn of December 2000. We are so blessed. We have never worked so hard in our life, but if there was ever any doubt as to whether UpReach was going to be here, that was the turning point. If we could do that, we could do anything. And a lot of you were here during that time and remember those days. It was hard. But I don't think there's anyone here that wouldn't tell you it was worth it. So we've come a long way since the year 2000. So how many of you have noticed there's a hole in the backside of that blue building as you come down the driveway? Well, newly elected vice president of the board of directors and our esteemed ringmaster this evening, Tom, has been working with me and has been so generous with his time to help coordinate the renovation of that building so that we will have another covered arena to be able to expand programming. And they're on track for end of July to have all of that done and ready to go to expand programming. So there's a lot of exciting stuff going on. We have a lot of, Kristen's been working hard as the program director, but focusing on special programs to work with groups that can come in and do a lot of unmounted experiential learning. A lot of great programs and interest there. I'm partnering with, as we said earlier, the ACERT team project launched the Manchester Police Department with Easter Seals New Hampshire and many other agencies and organizations to expand unmounted programming and use that building to be able to provide that. And I will share with you, God has been good to us. We had a donor step forward and donate every penny we needed to do the renovation of that building because they believe in our programming so much. So kudos to that donor. They wish to remain anonymous, but we can thank them in our hearts and minds for the tremendous gift they have made. Here's our girl. Hey, Sarah. Smiling Sarah. Next time you come around, Sarah, you'll have to stop and tell them what you call me. She has a special name for me. I love it. The staff would do well to remember it.
But I have to tell you, we are so excited about opportunities. We have someone looking at the two-family house on the hill to actually talk about using that as a residential facility to provide residential programming to individuals with special needs. So the fact that we can increase the use of our facility and focus on mission-driven programming is exciting, exciting, exciting stuff. It's nice to know that while we will still, as you know, continue to move forward with a number of fundraising initiatives, and fundraising will always be key, that we are in a very positive cash flow position. I don't think there's a demo night I've been able to tell you that. I've always been able to say things are good, things are great. And things are great because of you, because you share our information from Facebook through social media, because you share with family and friends, because you put posters out in the community and you talk about the benefits of programming. So we are in a very cash flow positive position. I like being able to sleep at night. It's a good thing. I don't feel quite like one of the presidents who 4 years later, you can't recognize them because they're so gray. All right, so Sarah, you're gonna tell them what you call me? Hold on. Boss lady, well, what kind of boss lady? She always calls me best boss lady. Best boss lady ever, right? Okay, well, yeah. The very best boss lady ever in the whole wide universe. Probably not. Best boss girl ever. All right, carry on. Carry on. I won't say what David Sullivan said I was. There's sometimes when we're a little too much like family. In all its goodness and ugliness. I have to tell you that when I go out into the community and talk about the power of UpReach and why horses and why it's so much more than just a pony ride, I often use Sarah as an example, and I'm grateful that she allows me to do so. Because they say, imagine if you will, that you are confined to a wheelchair for a good part of the time, and that you can come in and you can leave your wheelchair behind and you can get on the back of a horse, and the minute you're on the back of the horse, the visible indicators of your disability disappear. And the smile on her face, because sometimes she comes in, she's a little cranky. Uh-huh. But when she gets up on her horse, the smile on her face lights up the room. And if I ever have to wonder why I need to dig a little deeper on a certain day to get a project done or make something happen, I think about Sarah. And I think about wanting to make sure that she has an opportunity to come in and ride and enjoy that freedom and independence and have that big old smile on her face. So unfortunately, Gabe was not feeling well tonight, so he was unable to participate, but we still have Jane, Sarah, and Ashley that are going to be doing... Oh, I'm Drew, I'm sorry. How did I get ahead? I got ahead. I'm on the right one. Oh, he's on the next page. My apologies. Oh, fire me now. All right. So Drew has been riding for 2 years. He's been working on improving his balance and core strength and body position, and he was the one where Lauren was going, get your hands up! And he did. And I give him credit because I probably couldn't do that. He's progressed by leaps and bounds and now maintains an upright torso for most of the lesson. He stops his horse independently with his reins and his voice, and he's also been developing his steering skills. Then we have Miss Sarah. She's found a great partner in Lars. Sarah and Lars have been working very hard on gaining independence at the walk. Sarah controls Lars with her leg aids and her reins, so he knows when to walk, trot, stop, and turn. Lars can be a clown sometimes, that's what they wrote. But Sarah's focus to the task at hand helps Lars keep his head in the game. Sarah can be a clown sometimes too. And then Ashley. Ashley is on Jilly. Ashley tells Jilly to walk on by pointing her index finger, working on stopping Jilly by lowering her hands towards the reins and maintaining her balance with just an ankle hold from her side walkers. And Ashley has been riding for about 2 years. And then Jane, one of our other celebrities for being here since almost the beginning of time, is on Clarissa. Jane is working on using her reins and develop independent skills. She also works on word recognition by participating in bingo. Her favorite activity is basketball, and I'm also delighted to say that Jane comes and volunteers while she's here, and it's a delight to have her as a volunteer as well as a participant in the program. Yes. Okay, everyone is doing something a little different. Allison, the instructor, has let me know that Sarah's going to be working on her posting. And then the other are going to be doing a stop. Jane's going to play basketball, one of her favorite activities, as we just heard. Ashley is going to play beanbag. And Drew is going to work on stopping between the cones. So again, the benefit of a group, but at the same time, they can all work on independent skills because of the wonderful assistance of our volunteers. And again, while everyone, while the concept of therapeutic riding is global across participants, each participant has an individualized lesson plan with very specific goals that they are working on. And we use a goal attainment scaling model and have independent raters come in after a certain number of weeks to evaluate how well the individuals are achieving the goals that have been established for them. So that is an independent measurement tool. And then from there, we can work on becoming better instructors, crafting stronger, more focused goals, as well as to be able to share the true efficacy and evidence-based practice of the work we're doing, which helps us with grant writing and fundraising. Because it is so much more than just a pony ride. Again, so Drew is going to be working on steering Chance through the cone. I would be remiss if I didn't say that UpReach was particularly blessed, and I am somewhat biased in this, to have such a fabulous staff. Not only are they passionate about the work they do, they are all PATH certified at some level as a therapeutic horseback riding instructor or driving instructor. Lauren also has received a certification in volunteer administration and management. Kristen is an equine specialist along with Allison, which allows them to assist in the mental health programming as the horse handler and working on the horse activities. Kristen is also EGALA certified. She has been doing an extensive amount of training using a master herder model, which will allow us to provide management level training and workshops using the horse as a model for effective management. So again, we continue to learn more about how our equine partners can help us be successful, whether it's in the corporate arena or the riding arena. See what I did there? Yeah, I did that on purpose. So as you can see, there's a lot of different activities going on, yet the horses are all still very calm and collected and just know what they need to do their job. We are very fortunate to have a wonderful staff focused on the horses. Danielle does an outstanding job with barn management and oversight, ensuring that the horses get what they need for exercise and other programming. Think of how you'd feel if all you did was go around the ring all day. So she makes sure they keep their heads on straight and they stay fit mentally and physically. Nice horse show round of applause. Nice job. Okay, they've received instructions to head to the letter A, and then they will steer through the cones. So how many of the folks in the audience have ever ridden a horse? Show of hands. Remember what those muscles felt like an hour later? For some of us, a day later, 2 days later? Well, that's the real fundamental basis for the physical therapeutic component of horseback riding. It helps to build those core trunk muscles, keep them strong, so that if you are sitting in a wheelchair, you can sit up straighter. When you sit up straighter, you digest your food better, you breathe better. So it's all connected and interconnected. Yes. Everyone is steering through the cones. And Sarah is doing it off lead. I think I have a picture of Dave Sullivan volunteering with Sarah when Sarah was about half his age. And David was half that age too. That's true, Allison.
But I think he was born with the beard.
Spirit of New Hampshire Volunteer Award, that's right. That's right, David received the Volunteer Spirit of New Hampshire Volunteer of the Year Award. Congratulations, David. He's a celebrity too, I guess. And Colleen, who is volunteering in this lesson, who will be stepping down as board chair this year, as a Region 1 Professional Association of Therapeutic Horsemanship volunteer. So she received national recognition. So we have a lot of celebrities here tonight. How about a nice horse show round of applause? What a nice job everyone has done tonight. Ashley's sitting up so nice and tall. Well done. Sarah's looking good on Lars, and look at Drew on Chance. Nice job. Yes, Chance, you're a handsome boy. Say no. Let me tell you, those horses know when I say nice things about them. Right, Clarissa? And a nice horse, a round of applause for Jane and Clarissa. Okay, they're going to line up so that we can get ready to do the presentation of medallions and certificates. Okay, one more. As soon as Drew gets up, we'll do one more nice horse show round of applause. And again, how about a nice horse show round of applause for Jane, Drew, Sarah, and Ashley. Well done. Yes, Lars, you'll get your reward in just a little bit. He is. He's like, it's all about the treats. See, the horses and the staff, food. Food oriented. And thank you to Wesley, our associate ringmaster. Oh, looks like you're on your own now, Tom. I think you'll be just fine, my friend. So while they are dismounting and we're getting ready for our next group, 25 years. I've been here for almost 20 of those 25 years. I started in September of 1998. I remember walking into the barn and the first thing I saw was a child facing backwards on the horse. I was not hired for my horse handling skills. I knew I had an excellent team of people that understood how to run programming, how to deliver safe lessons. What they needed was someone who was willing to be a PR person, a marketing person, a financial person, a budget person, and then help focus and direct programming and make sure we could stretch that penny further and further and further and further and make sure we had more pennies to stretch. So while I was terrified at the same time, I couldn't have been more excited about the direction that the good Lord had put me in to be here and take all the things that I had learned in my 33 years and make a difference in the community. Do you realize that in 25 years, through all of the help of so many individuals, so many grantors, so many cans in the community or at the supermarket you saw a can and you put your spare change in, to car washes, to bake sales, to whatever the case may be. Do you realize that UpReach has provided almost $500,000 in scholarship awards to participants to help make it easier for them to ride or drive in the program? You all are a part of that. That's awesome. We have expanded from when I started, we did programming until 5 o'clock in the evening. One of the first programs we initiated was Gimme Five, which meant we started riding from 5 o'clock and 6 o'clock. And actually back in the day, we also had a 7 o'clock class. So we expanded the number of people who could participate. We worked hard. There were a lot of, when I first started, there were 33 participants in the program. And probably almost the same number of horses we have today. So I put my financial hat on and went, how do we become sustainable? So we talked with the program staff and we figured out how to do more group lessons to still make them appropriate, effective, so that the kids could have more fun by being more interactive in lessons. And it also allowed us to expand the capacity of people we could serve in the community. We have grown from a staff of 4.5 to 9. I'm proud to say that as of July 1st, Liz too will be coming on as a full-time staff person, and we will be fully staffed in all of our programming for the first time in the 20 years I've been here. So that's exciting stuff. We are so delighted to know that we are working, we're in conversation to talk about whether there are some conservation things that we can do to ensure that we are taking good care of our 98 plus acre farm and making sure that we treasure the gift we have of the black gum trees, the white Atlantic cedar. Those are some rare tree populations that we have on our property. We also have some other bushes and things like that that are noticeably rarer in the New Hampshire community that we need to be good stewards of, to think about how we do that, how we share that with the community. What else? Let's see, we have 13 very capable, hardworking board members that are moving this organization forward in a way that we have never been able to focus on and do before. So I would like to take this moment to ask, if you were on the board of directors of UpReach, if you could just stand for a moment and allow us to acknowledge you or raise your hand and your hard work, because you guys have moved us beyond the tough decisions of how do we keep the doors open back in 2000 to moving forward, expanding programming, being in a good financial position, and being good stewards of the funding that we do have. Let's see, 25 years. Who has a memory? Who has a memory to share? Any particular? So let's talk about the hoedown. 25 years, we thought it was only fitting that this year, instead of our Diamonds and Denim Gala, we will be back at the Manchester Country Club on Friday, October 13th with our 25th anniversary Cowboy Ball, a tribute to the hoedown. So it's the hoedown with no carpets to set up or tear down, no village scene to set up or tear down, no bars to set up or tear down. I'm liking it already. But I share with you that Karen Morgan and Pony Express will be back to perform at the Manchester Country Club. We will have line dancing. So we're going to pull out all the stops, but we're just going to make it simple. But we're going to have the hoedown as a tribute to the 25th on October 13th at the Manchester Country Club. So we hope you'll mark that date on your calendar and come on back, and you can see how much the band has aged as well. So let's see. I told you all about Wounded Warrior Project, right? June 24th. If you know anybody that's a Wounded Warrior that would like to participate, have them let us know so that we can sign them up for that. What else? What am I missing, Tom? Can you think of anything? Ah, I know what I'm forgetting. How many of you saw all of our posts about New Hampshire Gives, how this past Tuesday into Wednesday was a 24-hour day of New Hampshire statewide philanthropic investment in the community? We had asked you all to help us raise $3,000 for scholarship. I am delighted to say, with a last-minute extraordinary gift from a last-minute anonymous donor, we exceeded our goal to $3,050. So we want to thank you for that contribution to scholarship. And we have our penny raffle, and for those of you who don't know, tickets are not a penny, although someone thought it was, and perhaps back in the day it used to. We have our penny raffle, so if you'd like to participate, all of the money from the penny raffle is going to go help support some prizes for our photo contest. So, if you have not heard about our photo contest, there are some flyers on the table as you come in, and you'll be hearing more about it. But we need to get some fresh photos in our archives that we can use on our website, on flyers and posters, to help share the message of what we do. So we're going to have a contest. There's four categories. There's $25 cash prizes for the winners in each of the categories, as well as a 11 by 17 print of your winning photo that you will get to keep, and that we will then put on canvas and post around the barn acknowledging you as the photographer. So we hope you'll participate in that, and that's gonna go through, I think, August 20th. So it starts tonight, goes through August 20th, so snap those photos tonight, and then share them with us. All the information about where to, and how to share them are on the official rules that are right by the bulletin board, so we hope you'll do that. I hope that some of you will take the opportunity when you're going in to grab a snack or a drink, that there should be a laptop in there that's playing a PowerPoint with a lot of photos from back in the day as well as the current day. So I hope that you'll stop and take a look, because I know I enjoyed some of the memories of seeing some of those little bitty kiddos that are now all grown up. And in fact, one of the little bitty kiddos on horseback in one of those photos and the PowerPoint is going to be doing independent cantering for you tonight. So it's really kind of cool. My kids are all growing up. Chrissy, what could I say? I remember when Leslie was this big.
It's been 12 years.
It's all, I just feel they're all my kids. And then I send them home to you.
And we send them back.
And then you keep sending them back. Yes, you do. And we are grateful. We are so glad. Mr. McGraw, how's it going over there? Everything good in the horse aisle? Okay, good to know. We're getting ready for our next demonstration. But I just can't say thank you enough to all of you who have done so much to make sure that we continue the magic. We encourage you to share your stories, to share why it's important and powerful to you, because we still have that question that we have to answer all the time as we're writing grants and going to speak to people who don't necessarily always get it. And your stories and your written testimonials allow Veronica and I to translate the message that makes them have that aha moment about why they should step up and volunteer or write that check or agree to do that fundraiser or donate the sound system or roofing materials or their plowing services, whatever it may be. I have to give a special thanks to, I know he wouldn't want it, but I would be remiss that for the 20 plus years I've been here, Dr. Cobb of Candray Pet Care in Candia continues to donate all of his services in caring for our horses. He believes that strongly in the power of what we do, that he's willing to make that happen, and that's a huge and generous gift that we are forever grateful for. I do have to say though, that gift is not surpassed. Probably about 10 years ago, a mom and her daughter walked into the barn and walked into the office and said, mom said, well, Olivia has something she'd like to give you. And Olivia had just celebrated her 8th birthday. And in lieu of presents, Olivia asked for people to make donations that she could bring to UpReach. So Olivia took all of her birthday money, $80.72, I will never forget that. $80.72, and gave all of her birthday money for her 8th birthday and brought it in and donated to UpReach. And she still comes in every year on her birthday and makes a donation to UpReach. That gift of everything she got for her 8th birthday is no less powerful than what Dr. Cobb does with all of his generosity, because that was everything for her. Everything she had for her 8th birthday. When kids do that, we know we're gonna be all right as a world. Our future is secure. Because she continues to give us all hope, and isn't that ultimately the only thing that's gonna get us through? And speaking of someone who's somewhat of a celebrity, Nicole is riding in this lesson. Nicole has been riding here for an awfully long time as well. When she's not in sledding accidents and having to take a significant amount of time off. Nicole also joined Kristen and I at National Conference and did a joint presentation with Kristen on choosing words with dignity. So we're really, really thrilled that Nicole can begin to advocate. And she's very passionate about that. And here's our assistant ringmaster, Wesley, who somehow grew up and has very long legs. And here she is in the ring, Miss Danielle, our Disney princess. I tease her. Nicole is riding Lulu. She's been working on her overall balance while riding and is continuing to learn how to use her body and her balance to help balance her horse. She's been working towards posting with no stirrups, and while trotting on the 20-meter circle and completing the dressage figure eight, Nicole is using her body and aids to help Lulu balance through her turns and help create a balanced and quality trot despite the tightness of the turns. Wesley is riding his trusty steed, Watson. He's also working on his balance by working on posting with no stirrups, although they have stirrups right now. See how good I am? I'm the least horse-savvy person, and I know that they have stirrups. See, there's hope for all of you as well. You don't have to know anything about horses to get connected. Trust me, I can hook you up. They're just like dogs, right, Tom? No. Watson can be quick at the trot, so Wesley's also working on bringing down his own energy and using his body cues to help Watson stay at a steady pace. Using the circle and dressage figure eight helps Wesley keep Watson paying attention to his rider, increasing the quality of work between horse and rider. So it's all about communication. I was just talking with Wesley's folks and just in awe of the composed, quiet hands, low energy young man that's riding that horse, that is using his words, that has good balance. And I look at Nicole and I see the quiet confidence that she exudes on the horse, that transfers off the horse when she's advocating and believes strongly in her future as a young woman in the community. They both make me very proud. Nice job. Good job, Wesley. Well done, Nicole. How about a nice horse show round of applause for all of them? Nice job. Well done, Nicole. I remember when you were itty bitty too. All my kids are grown up. Nice job. So we're gonna let the ringmaster give a medal and certificate, and then we're gonna hear from another special young lady. Lulu's ready for her close-up. So Tom, your assistant ringmaster rode, are you gonna ride next?
No.
No? Okay. You and me, drill team next year.
No, I only want the horses.
Why are you laughing? This year was, gee, Ronica, this was the year you and I were supposed to ride in on our trusty steeds.
Next year.
Next year.
Actually, we have some stick ponies.
I was gonna say, can you go grab a couple of stick ponies and we'll take care of that. So as I'm talking about staff, many of you may not have met Veronica. Veronica, just wave to everyone. Veronica is our development director. She writes grants, and her grants provide magical things like tractors with buckets, a brand new horse trailer, a ride-on lawnmower and snowblower, scholarship funds, and all kinds of other lovely things. So we are very grateful to Veronica for being behind the scenes and doing a lot of that hard work. She also is responsible for staying on top of things with social media. If any of you are on Facebook and you have not liked the UpReach page, may I encourage you to please do so? Was that good? Is that good? Thank you. So I encourage you to like UpReach, share our Facebook posts. We try not to be too crazy and post too many times. Is that Cassandra? Is that Cassandra over there? No? I thought I saw her. Nope, okay. We are delighted that Veronica started with us as an intern from St. Anselm's College, and when she graduated, I scooped her up. Let's see, Lauren started with us as a intern from Colby Sawyer. We scooped her up. Kristen was a volunteer. We scooped her up. So if you're looking for a job here, you might want to start volunteering, because it seems like that's the road we go. Do we have a quick minute that I can ask all the staff to come forward?
Not really.
Not really? Can I make an executive decision? No? Is it okay if we stop everything for just a minute? Because I'd really like to introduce the staff, and I don't want everybody to leave. Because a lot of you are going to start speaking out. I know you. Can I ask all the staff to come forward really quickly? I have to tell you that as an executive director, things would be a lot harder if I didn't surround myself with excellent, excellent people. Yes. So I am truly honored and blessed to be surrounded by a group of very, and no offense, it just happened this way, but very highly capable, qualified, passionate, dedicated young women. And so when you talk about girl power, this is it. So let me take a minute to introduce them.
Hold on. Oh, yeah, start with me because I got to go.
Lauren Kachakian is the assistant program director. She puts together all of the schedule and ensures that we have the best possible partnerships between horse and rider and makes it all run like a fine, well-oiled machine. As I said before, Lauren is a PATH certified therapeutic riding instructor, driving instructor. She has her certificate in volunteer management. She received the Governor's Award, or the Judith Longren Award for volunteer administration and management. So we are very proud and honored, and that's just the highlight of the gifts that she brings. I can't think of someone who has more heart for the program than Lauren. So thank you. Now be off with you. Go do what you need to do. Because I know you're standing there going, I have a million things to do. Our program director, Kristen McGraw. Kristen started as a volunteer with her family, felt that it was important as a family to volunteer together and make a difference in the community. Kristen is a certified therapeutic riding instructor, driving instructor, equine specialist. She's EGALIS certified. She's been going to more trainings and becoming more aware. She is a great ambassador for UpReach in the community. It is actively working with other community partners to see how we can collaborate to deal with whether it's addiction and the opioid issue, trauma, veterans programming. She's the Energizer Bunny of the group, and she's the one that keeps me go when I say whoa. So thank you, Kristen. We appreciate your dedication and commitment and support. We have Liz Devine. Liz is one of the newest members of the team. I'm delighted to say that she's going to be coming on board full-time as of July 1. We are so excited. We are so excited that we could financially make that happen. It was no other issue other than financially. We needed to know we could make payroll every single week because I think that's kind of important. She is a graduate of UNH with a degree in equine... Equine Studies with a track in therapeutic riding. She is a certified therapeutic riding instructor, and as I mentioned earlier, she's also working on becoming a therapeutic driving instructor. She has a wonderful, calm demeanor about her with just enough of a bit of snarkiness that it keeps us all laughing and on our toes. She is your volunteer coordinator. She is the one who makes sure that we can continue to do what we do by finding all of the volunteers and making sure that they are trained and they trust her, and when she calls, they come, and we are so ultimately grateful for that, so thank you. Oh, and don't forget, she's wearing the Frozen robe thing in the penny raffle, so she wants to make sure she gets the most. She wants to get the most, more tickets than Lauren in the Minnie Mouse one, so. Just saying. Takes a village. And then we have Danielle, Danielle Martin, recently married. We are delighted to have Danielle on the team. She is the barn manager as well as a certified therapeutic riding instructor. And as I mentioned earlier, Danielle works hard to ensure that the herd is happy and healthy. She works hard on the tractor, taking care of the facility. She is our tractor girl, and no one is more excited about the tractor than Danielle. And she is just, again, a sweet, warm energy, but is such a hard worker. And she really is that quiet energy of the barn, and we're delighted to have her as part of the team. So thank you. Then there's Allison. Allison is a certified therapeutic riding instructor, and Allison used to be our barn manager, and she shares the barn duties and helps take care of all of the horses, but she's also stepped up to the role of being helping Kristen create and develop special programs. So she is stretching her skills. She is also a certified equine specialist. She assists the mental health practitioner with the equine portion of her programming and lessons. And Allison is actually writing the curriculum for the brand new vocational program that we are hoping to roll out in September in conjunction with Easter Seals New Hampshire and New Hampshire Voc Rehab. So she is stretching her non-horse muscle to be able to allow us to expand programming and services. And we are really excited about the growth. And she, again, is, a quiet energy in the barn that we're delighted to have here. She kind of sort of is, yeah. Although she does a lot of skipping, it's a very quiet skipping.
You're just comparing yourself to Kristen.
Oh, compared to Kristen the Energizer Bunny, yes. And then, as I said, Veronica writes the grants, raises the money, helps make sure that we can actually write all the checks and pay all the bills and get all the shiny new stuff. And all of a sudden, I'll hear over the world, Veronica, we need a... And Veronica...
Help the copier's broken.
Yes. So we, but we're delighted that we have Veronica behind the scenes. Again, to quote a former board member, she is like a swan where underneath the water her legs are paddling 600 miles an hour, but above the water she is floating serenely along. So we are delighted to have Veronica here. And really, if you want to volunteer with Veronica, she's really great people, and we're looking for folks that can give Veronica some support as well.
And then there's Karen, who is our amazing executive director that I've had the privilege of working with and for since 2000. And, you know, together we stood out in that driveway in 2000 on March 10th and said that we will get through this. And we did, and we have, and we're bigger and better than ever. So thank you, Karen.
It's my pleasure.
Now get back to work. Stop your slacking. But I would be remiss if I didn't say that your staff is the heart of the organization. And while we are so delighted that we give them a paycheck on a regular basis, it's not a large one. And we are delighted that they keep coming back and they find so much more gratitude than just being able to bring home a paycheck. We are so incredibly honored to have them here working and doing what needs to get done. I'm trying to discreetly get out of the way and it's not working. All right, back to the program. Thank you for that. Thank you for letting us do a staff advertisement. And here's one of our flag bearers. He's now on horseback. I think where he probably prefers. Watson, you're getting some quality time tonight, buddy.
Yeah, he sure does.
Everyone wave and say hello to Ben. So this next demonstration is going to be Ben, Chris, and Trinity. So Ben, as you introduced yourselves and waved as he went by, he was previously a driving student who's transitioned to riding this year. And increasing his off-lead time in lessons as he begins to develop his independent riding skills and to demonstrate safety when riding in a group. Trinity is riding one of our newest horses, Ruby. Everyone wave and say hello to Trinity and Ruby. Trinity began riding just last summer. She's a quick learner and applies the concepts discussed to her riding, and her favorite skill is posting. And doesn't she look outstanding on one of our newest horses? And then there's Chris. Chris started riding in 2009. They are doing a last minute tack check and then Chris will be underway. But Chris is currently working on steering, stopping and posting at the walk and trot. He loves riding in the woods and chatting with his volunteers, especially Mr. McGraw. And this year, Chris has made great improvements in his balance on his horse and posting trot skills. So while they are getting ready and warming up, I just want to let everyone know that I didn't give them to you earlier because I didn't want them to get flung or through the arena while we were doing our demos. But Jess or Cassie, if you could get the box of Frisbees out and put next to the door so people can take one as they leave, that would be awesome. But we have some special Frisbees with our new UpReach branding logo, tagline, and color palette. So if you would all take a Frisbee on your way out the door, we would love to have you have it. It makes a great plate holder. So if you, you know, go to the beach and you need a plate, and then you can turn it over and play Frisbee. I think of these things. We didn't get a chance, we didn't let you speak yet. Come on up while they're warming up. While they're warming up, I'm gonna have Sophia speak a little bit about, can you talk to us about your favorite thing about riding?
And I like cantering.
She likes cantering. Did you start off cantering the first thing you got here?
Kind of.
Not sure I like that answer. Maybe unintentionally you started cantering. You did progress really fast. So what do you think riding does for you? Does it keep you balanced? Does it make you think, are you smarter because you ride? I don't know.
It gives me more muscles, and I have a fun experience continuing to actually ride a horse.
So do you think that the horse gets you?
It depends on the horse.
Good answer. Good answer. So what is it about Murphy that made the relationship with you and Murphy so special?
He taught me how to canter, and I just really love him because he's like really gentle and kind.
And who are you riding now?
I've been switching on and off with horses.
Okay, so you're testing them all out for us. Okay. All right, so thanks very much for coming up and sharing some words with us. We'll let them get underway, and then you're going to ride for us later, right? Okay. We'll see who you're riding tonight, who you're testing out for us tonight. I will say, Soph's one of those ones that kind of came and got on, and right away you knew she was meant to be a horsewoman. She just sat like a horsewoman. She just got it.
She's like, you want something? She's like, yes.
I have pictures of you when you were little, Alyssa. I don't think she's paying attention either. So what are you going to be having them do, Lauren?
Right now we are demonstrating a surf routine. So we're doing a steering figure. And we're going to do it twice as our maiden voyage. And then we're going to be demonstrating some squatting.
Excellent.
And Chris will be working on their posting. And then we'll be demonstrating a sitting drop when we get there.
So right now they're working on their serpentine figures. They're going to do that twice. Nice job, Mr. McGraw. Trinity hasn't been riding that long, and she looks wonderful. I was going to say.
Last summer.
Last summer, wow.
Yeah, Bill.
It didn't go here.
Looking good, Chris. Watch where you're going, my friend.
Who are you?
I'm Karen. Trinity's doing a wonderful job on Miss Ruby. This is Ruby's first demo night. She's so pretty. Nice job, Ben.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Bye.
Have a nice horseshoe round of applause for Chris and his team doing a nice job tonight. We're glad that Chris decided to join us for demo night. Chris, eyes forward. Watch where you're going. There you go. Good job. I know, there's so much going on. So for those of you who are wondering what's going on, what's coming up at UpReach, there's an information table over by the bulletin board. We are hosting a free trauma-informed presentation. We encourage anybody that's interested in finding out more about trauma and trauma care and resiliency to join us for that. There's no charge, just bring a bag lunch. We'd love to have you. But there's a bunch of other information about some other activities and programs coming up as well. Nice job, Trinity. Okay, just draw your attention. Ben's going to trot down the long side. A nice sitting trot. Oh.
Hi, Chris.
A nice horseshoe round of applause for Ben and Watson, and also for Colleen. She's getting quite a workout in tonight. Oh my goodness, I'm so tired I had to sit down, Colleen. Looking good, Watson, buddy. Yes, you are. A nice horseshoe round of applause for Chris and Chance and his team. Nice job, Chance, buddy. Look at him looking at like, do you love me? Does the crowd love me? You're a good boy, Chance. You too, Bill. Nice job, Ben. A nice horseshoe round of applause one more time for Ben and his trusty Steed Watson. Are you talking back, Ben?
That horse?
You talking back to that horse?
Yeah.
Nice job.
Thank you.
So they're gonna trot on the long side, other direction. For those of you who might not be aware, our lesson structure is typically 1 hour for the riding lessons, 1 hour a week, or anywhere from 6 to 8 weeks in a term length that our participants come. And driving lessons are half an hour. Nice job. Horse show round of applause one more time for Chris Chance and his trusty team. And we'll watch as Ben and Watson trot down alongside. Nice job. And one more horse show round of applause for a job well done. And tell me this isn't a good match. Trinity on Miss Ruby. Nice. Quiet, controlled. Beautiful, beautiful. Nice horse show round of applause for Trinity and her trusty steed Ruby. So while they're doing one last trot, just need to give some special thanks to a couple of other folks. We'd like to thank the Parkman Family Foundation for their generosity in continuing to sponsor our Greater Boston Charity Horse Show on Memorial Day weekend at the Topsfield Fairground. They make a sizable cash donation every year to help make sure that that show is a success and a great fundraiser for us as well. We'd also like to thank so many other foundations and organizations. Queen City Rotary has recently made a grant award to us that's going to help us move the trauma-informed care program forward. They're also great at coming out and providing food as a wrap-up for our Heron Pond school kiddos when they come out for their programming. It looks like they are just about ready to line up to receive their medallions and certificates. I encourage you to pick up a copy of last year's annual report, and when we have this year's annual report published and ready, I encourage you to pick that up and note all the outstanding achievements that we've experienced this past year, new programming, the financial gains, and again, our thanks for all of the folks that will be listed in that who share their support with us. Chance, you did a good job, buddy. Watson, well done. And I can't tell you, Trinity, what a beautiful job on Ruby, one of our brand new horses. Did a great job, both of them. I'd like to thank the staff for working with all of our volunteers and the volunteers for stepping up and making the commitment to go through the Taking the Lead program. Any of our horse handlers, nice job, Ben. Any of the horse handlers have had to learn a new technique in how they're handling and leading our horses that provides consistency to all of the horses, so that regardless of who's leading them, which has really been a great help to help make sure the horses are happy. Nice job. Again, one last horse show round of applause. This was an excellent group. Well done.
You're pretty good at it.
A nice hand for Tom doing other duties as requested. Tom is a board member. Tom is a volunteer in riding and driving lessons. I hear that one of the things that they really enjoy about having Tom as a volunteer is that he's always encouraging his horse and rider. Tom also is one of the few people I know that looks forward to coming and walking horses up and down the hill. Walking the horses up and down the hill helps build important muscle for the horses to stay happy and healthy. And I gotta tell you, it's not a job that I would want to do. But I know that Tom looks forward to doing it and encourages horses that when they get done, they can come back and have their breakfast. So he's a delight to have as a volunteer. We're very pleased and grateful to have him. We're getting ready for our last demo. And so while we're getting ready for that, Lindsay, who is a volunteer and a new board member, is going to make some remarks.
Warm in here with all these people, that's great. My name is Lindsay, and first of all, I really want to thank you for coming tonight. I've been volunteering at UpReach for just over a year or so, and it's been so incredibly impactful on my life, and that has a lot to do with all of you here, so thank you very, very much. I started coming about a year ago, like I said, because I was looking to do something that would help make someone else's life better. And of course, little did I know how much it would help improve my life. The folks that I've met here are so inspiring. Everyone, the clients that come, and their courage, and sometimes you know their bravery and their optimism, and the staff is just so so creative. They come up with a solution for everything, and whatever they need to do or whatever they want to do, somehow they find a way to do it, and that's really, really great. So I wanted to share with you some of the things I've learned from some of the riders that I've had a chance to interact with. There's one lady who comes and she uses a wheelchair and she needs a lot of physical support in order to ride her horse. And to me, if I were her, I would be kind of scared, you know, to get out of the comfort of my wheelchair and get on this moving, wobbly horse. And when she comes, she is so optimistic, and she smiles, and she laughs the entire time. And to me, that's really what courage looks like. And there's another young man that I see quite a lot, and he comes in, and he just is always in the best mood. He never has a bad day. Nothing ever gets him down. And he goes out of his way to be kind to the other clients that he rides with. And you know, together, the two of them and everybody that I meet here, they inspired me to be more courageous, more optimistic, more creative, and just in general to be a kinder person in my day-to-day life. Everyone here is just so kind and helpful and brave and creative, and they're just awesome. And it's really been a blessing to be a part of this community. So I wanted to say thank you for also coming here and being all a part of this, because if it weren't for you guys coming here and having this need, then I wouldn't be here, and it wouldn't impact me the way that it does. So thank you very much. I hope you enjoy the rest of your evening and have a safe drive home. Thank you again for coming.
Thank you. Thank you again, Lindsay. I think Lindsay said something that resonated with me that I've heard year after year, time after time, that so many people come up to me and say, you know, I volunteered because I wanted to come here and I wanted to make a difference in someone else's life. And yet I find that my life is the one that's changed, irrevocably changed in a better way. And we are so grateful and so humbled by the fact that it's truly a testimony to the fact that we all have value. We all deserve to be here. We all have our challenges and obstacles. Some of them are more visible than others. But nonetheless, we are part of a community. All of us are part of a community, and it's together that we can be our best selves. So I thank you for allowing us to continue to kind of stand in that and live in that and believe in that. We have one more demonstration before tonight's 25th anniversary demonstration is over. Thank you for staying to the end. We are grateful because there is a lot of talent in the ring right now that we are excited to share with you. As I mentioned earlier, I was talking with Mom because there's a picture of one of the folks in this lesson of when she first started riding, and she was itty bitty on the horse and her legs barely could straddle the horse, and tonight she's going to canter for you. And she comes and volunteers at the barn, and she is Kristen's double when it comes to being the Energizer Bunny. There's nothing that's ever going to hold her back. And I think one of the things that horseback riding gives her, though, is a way to kind of channel and focus that energy. Because when she channels and focuses that energy and she goes out into the world, it's going to be a powerful force and she's going to do great things. So last, but certainly not least, the final demo of the evening. Is everybody feeling good? Yeah, we're feeling good, Allison. So we have Nick on Ruby. We have Sophia on Lulu. Zach is riding Boone. And Delaney is riding Lena. And with her love of pink, Delaney could be Allison's twin.
This is awesome. Thank you. We still haven't decided yet. I said the judges haven't decided yet.
Exactly. Just stay out of the way.
Yes, they said they wanted to make sure you knew Nick definitely knows how to canter, and yes, he does. In fact, I think at the last demo night, Nick said he was going to teach me how to ride, and so he owes me a lesson. So Allison will figure that out. You said canter. Sorry, but I don't know who looks prouder, Nick or Lulu.
She looks amazing.
Nice horse show round of applause for Nick and Lulu. Well done, Nick. So let me introduce to you this fine group of riders. Zach on Boone. Delaney on Lena.
Yep.
I got it right, yes.
Well done, Karen.
Nick on Lulu, and then Soph is coming up on Ruby. And if anyone is interested in learning more about the Wounded Warrior Project group, just tuck in with Zechariah, he's helping. He is a Wounded Warrior facilitator, peer facilitator, and has helped us with a support group here, and we're delighted to have him moving forward with some additional Wounded Warrior programming. So thanks, Zach. He also takes some great pictures, and we're delighted that his service dog, Dexter, brings him every week. Nice horse show round of applause for all of this group. Fantastic way to end the demonstrations tonight.
Nice job, you guys. All right. Everybody got your work.
Canter off into the sunset.
No, stop, eight mil.
I was not saying that.
All three of them, all four of them will. Hey, off your work.
So again, on behalf of all of us at UpReach, thank you so much for coming to our demo night. We hope that you've enjoyed the evening. I know that this has been an absolutely splendid way to celebrate our 25th anniversary. I can't think of a better group of people to surround myself with. You are the heart and soul of the organization, and we are delighted that we can welcome you into our home. And we encourage you to come back often and always. And on that note, thank you so much. Take care, God bless. Make sure you take something to eat with you if there's still food left. Take a beverage, and again, on behalf of all of the volunteers and staff and service learners and board of directors at UpReach, many blessings. Have a great weekend, and we'll see you next year. Good night.
Thank you.
I was so proud of myself to set my straight.